Welcome everyone to World Aquarium Singapore, where you see aquarium fishes and pets. And today, let's go to Blue Crystal Aquarium, where we learn how to take care of Arowana fishes, and also we learn how to select a good Arowana fish as well, alright? So, and also we got to see super red and rare Arowana fishes with this aquarium shop tour, and most importantly, learn how BCA was started, Mr. Yap's challenges and his rewards. And if you're new, consider subscribing and smash the like button. Thank you very much. So right now you're looking at Mr. Yap doing some maintenance, alright? So what are we waiting for? Let's dive right in, alright? And also these are all his list of grand champion, first prize, second prize winnings, alright, throughout the years, alright. All these I don't think they come easy, alright. And also a lot of efforts and determination and courage into it. Instead also sell other tropical fishes as well, exotic fishes as well, alright. This is the BCA logo, alright. Later I'll show you all how big this super red dragon signboard is. Alright, so stay tuned. Wow, look at that. The signboard is even bigger, taller than Mr. Yap himself. Look at this, wow. And next up, let's see the love tail super red dragon. Alright, and also we'll also be seeing other very beautiful and rare arowanas in BCA. Okay, let's go. And also you're going to see super red albino arowana, one of the most expensive and beautiful arowana which Mr. Yap has. Alright, so stay tuned. This is Danium Centaurum, Kalimantan, Indonesia. Alright, this lake is the origin of the super red arowana, and Mr. Yap and other experts have been invited to be the judges of this super red arowana competition. This is one of the very beautiful golden crossback arowana in Mr. Yap's monster tank. It's right at the back, and inside there's a giant catfish and other really huge fishes as well. Alright, enjoy guys. Wow, look at this red arowana. This is large and it's not the biggest yet. Giant ripsaw catfish and black diamond. Wow, next is this gold head blue base crossback arowana. These are very very beautiful. This super red is super duper red. Wow. And in order to get such a beautiful arowana fish, right, so you got to have a constant care, dedication, water changes, the correct food. Also another important thing according to Mr. Yap is tanning, right? You got to have the correct tanning equipment like what you are seeing right now down here. The placement of the tanning light bulb is also very important. Alright, so you got to have the correct level so that it shines onto your arowana. Another gold head blue base crossback arowana. I believe this beautiful piece has been sold. Look at that, look at the head and the form and the body. Wow, super wow. And if you'd like to see more of such grand champion albino super red arowanas, do subscribe for more and share as well. thanks, and thanks for Mr. Yap sharing all these beautiful clips with me as well. Wow. This is another one and only Super Red Albino Arowana. Look at that. Wow, wow, wow. Coming up next, more Super Red Arowana fishes from BCA. I also like to thank Mr. Yap for sharing these clips with me as well. Beautiful arowanas and rare arowanas. Next are very beautiful albino arowanas, right? And later Mr. Yap is going to show you all how to take care of your arowana fish and also how to select a good arowana fish as well. So stay tuned. Another super large super red arowana from BCA as well. Look at that. Wow. And if you are interested in joining arowana competition, there are a few categories. The first category is an extra large category. The second is large category, medium category, small category, a unique category, and some might add in a short body category as well. Wow, can you believe this color? Look at that, look at the red, the blue. Wow. Wow, look at this albino. Albino are one of the most expensive arowana. And next are some more rare arowanas. Wow, and look at this Zantic Super Red. Wow, it looks like so like flexible, their body, super beautiful. Wow, have you seen this big of an albino Super Red Arowana before, a full grown one? Wow, beautiful. Next up, Mr. Yap will share his history in English, where I will add the subtitles.
Hi, I'm Yap. I opened aquarium shop 20 years ago. First open aquarium shop is a floor horn shop, 20 plus year lah. After change to go to farm, try to feeding project. First is feeding project is a floor horn feeding project. After change to arowana feeding project, and until now around 10 year plus 11 year. And then after start the arowana feeding project for 2009, because younger and no enough money to invest in feeding project. Just sell off my home and the money invest to arowana. Then feeding project start to second year, and then the feeding project the fish are die, many lost many money. And then the time I want to give up. I slowly give up and then tell my wife I don't want to really. Then my wife said, never mind, I think my brother money help you again, one more time. After third year, not easy to start the feeding process because money no involved. Until now, I also remember the second year, the lost many money in my life. Here the hardship. My arowana business more stable. Thank you, my friend and supporter, and support me many years. I 非常感谢，非常谢谢你们一直以来的支持。我会把更好的龙鱼、更漂亮的龙鱼带给大家。I want to be more and more beautiful Arowana for everyone. 大家好，其实要养一条龙鱼是很简单嘛。龙鱼其实也是很容易养的。只要那个玻璃跟那个水啊，多加注意，然后勤劳放水。只要你观察它的龙鱼的那个工作，它的动态，这样你慢慢你就会学到里面的奥妙。比如讲龙鱼，它观察不好的时候啊，它会有奇怪的动作，比如讲飘缸啊，飘上来了，或者是说，停留在缸另外一个角度，不大要动。看到这种情形，我们就要检查那个水玻璃或者哪里环节我们出了问题。然后那个喂食方面，我们就下肉为主，然后偶尔可以一个 supper 就是讲来小鱼啊，然后换水啊，换点维他命水啊，换点维他命水，就是每个礼拜我们就是要换水了。每个礼拜要换水，就30%的水到50%，我认为会比较理想。接下来我想跟大家分享哦，怎么选一条漂亮的龙鱼。比如讲金龙方面哈，我们就选它的身体的亮度比较好，然后它的那个身体的亮度要比较高，然后那个鱼啊就。身体的比例要很正常，红龙方面呢，我们就是选，红鳟啦，体型棒啦，尾巴大啦，然后最重要我们选那个鱼的健康。其实，最后我要补充一句啊，其实选龙鱼啊，那个基因是最重要的，所以我们买龙鱼要懂得它的那来源，就是种鱼漂亮，它的孩子也漂亮。其实在这么多年那个比赛的过程我印象最深刻的是那个2017年的那个广州的阿瓜拉玛啦，因为在中国的广州的阿瓜拉玛倒数如赢，要赢的前边也是不容易了，结果那次还赢得总冠军回来，所以我那次印象最深刻。
我玩具。